Hi, I'm Dr. Julie Brahmer. I'm a medical oncologist at Johns Hopkins. Lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer-related deaths. In fact, lung cancer kills more patients than breast cancer, colon cancer, and ovarian cancer combined. Lung cancer affects both smokers as well as non-smokers. Immunotherapy is a promising new treatment for lung cancer. In some cases, it can actually extend patients' lives. Now let me go to the toy box and tell you more about it. So I'm going to use finger paints today to help explain how the immune system and the cancer interact. So this is your cancer cell. And this is your T cell, which is an important cell in your body that helps control and fight cancer. The cancer cell actually excretes abnormal proteins that are then taken up by another immune cell called the dendritic cell. This cell processes these proteins and presents them to the T cell so that the T cell can recognize the cancer. Then the T cell can go in and kill the cancer. But unfortunately, the cancer cell can do various things to try to prevent the immune system from attacking it by excreting different cytokines or even putting up a shield called a checkpoint. To explain the next idea, let's push this aside and talk about what a checkpoint is. A checkpoint pathway is what our body normally uses to control its immune system. There are several checkpoint pathways that our body uses. The pathway that we know most about is called the PD-1 pathway, and we're going to use a set of lock and keys to be able to explain this. This toy, actually, you can put the key in and unlock, and we can use this to explain the checkpoint pathways. So our immune system has checkpoint pathways to control itself. Normally, proteins can bind to a receptor and then unlock this lock and cause the immune system to be controlled. There's various different checkpoint pathways that we have here that help control the immune system. The one pathway that we know most about is called the PD-1 pathway. This pathway actually is used by cancer cells. The cancer cells express the protein, the T cells have the receptor, they bind, unlock that lock, and cause the T cells to be exhausted and go away. Next, we'll use the dragon to represent the cancer cell, and these superheroes to represent the immune cells or the T cells that are surrounding the dragon in an attempt to slay it. But the dragon is really smart and uses these checkpoint pathways to shield itself from the immune system. Here at Johns Hopkins and other institutions, we've helped develop antibodies. These antibodies are drugs that block the checkpoint pathway and actually break down the shield so that your immune system can slay the dragon. This is a real milestone for our lung cancer patients. For some patients, they are living longer and better lives when being treated with immunotherapy. But unfortunately, it does not help all of our patients. Here at Johns Hopkins, we are working hard to individualize this type of treatment to broaden the success in order to help all of our lung cancer patients.